I'm Don Was, president of Blue Note Records, and our guest today on First Look is the esteemed trumpeter, cornetist, and composer Ron Miles. Now, since 1987, he's recorded a string of brilliant albums and performed with a wide array of musicians, ranging from Ginger Baker to Bill Frisell to Josh Redman. We're here today to talk about his brand new album, Rainbow Sign, which features Brian Blade on the drums, Bill Frisell on guitar, Jason Moran on piano, and Thomas Morgan on the bass. Ron, it's good to see you, man.
Good to see you, Don.
Thank you. Congratulations on a beautiful new album, and welcome to the Blue Note family, man. Bill turned me on to the new music. He emailed me some MP3s, and I remember playing it right away one night while I was driving around. I was in Burbank, California, which is not necessarily the most visually breathtaking location on the earth. But as your music played, I got really misty-eyed and emotional. Everything, the Shell gas station on the corner and the pizza joint right next to it, everything looked so poignant and beautiful while listening to your music. And when we spoke subsequently, I learned that this album was made during a very emotional time for you. Let's talk about that.
I wrote this music when my father was transitioning from this world to his eternal life. I think that when writing music, it seems like a lot of us, I think, feel we have to be in an emotional place that maybe we haven't been to, or want to be able to deal with some things that are going on in our life. And the music gives us a place to put those thoughts and those feelings. And so this record is a chance for me to reflect on my dad.
That's beautiful, man. Let's talk about this incredible band that you put together. All of these musicians have some deep ties to Blue Note. How did you end up with all these guys in one room?
Well, that, as you know, is a tricky thing. We've all worked together in different contexts. I've played in Jason's band, and Brian and Bill and I have played together. Thomas and I had not met before we did our previous record, I Am a Man. And but when we played together, it just gave me everything that I could want in an ensemble. As you know, these are the greatest musicians, some of them have ever played their instruments. Mm-hmm. And so I feel like my job is to give them as much song as possible, because they are all master song players.
So it's a great band, man. The title for the album, Rainbow Sign, that's very poetic. Can we talk about what it means to you?
Yeah, I think that rainbows have traditionally been this kind of almost kind of freeway or passageway from heaven to earth. And so it allows us to visit those who've gone on and those who've gone on to come back and visit us from time to time.
Let's play a little bit of that song, Rainbow Sign. That's Rainbow Sign from the new album of the same title by Ron Miles. Now, The Rumor is the song that really got to me when I was stopped at that traffic light.
Well, you know, The Rumor, when I wrote it, I was thinking of the courage to love in the face of a time when maybe that's not the accepted way that it could be. And so even thinking like of this couple, the loving couple, remember they were the couple who really struck down these kind of interracial marriage laws. And I think about contemporary times too, when we get same-sex marriages. But what one thing that we didn't talk about is Bill was inducted into my high school's Hall of Fame years ago, and he didn't get to go to the ceremony, but I went. And a friend of his talked about Bill playing a talent show at East High School when he was in high school and playing Bumpin' on Sunset. And so when I wrote it, I could hear it like Wes or Bill or one of those folks playing, like just playing the song so soulfully. And so when he put his thing on it, I said, there we go. That's it right there.
All right, let's give that a listen. That's the rumor from the new Ron Miles album, Rainbow Sign. Now, you told me that Queen of the South was inspired by the R&B music coming out of Ethiopia in the 60s and 70s. Let's talk about that a little
bit. Yeah, particularly Dexter Story. Yeah, Dexter Story was a musician who music really grabbed me. And I went back recently and listened to it because I've said that music is part of it. And I can't exactly hear where I got something from Dexter Story, but just the spirit of it like made me think like, oh yeah, I know what to do now. And I think that's one of the great things about music, right? And I feel that with a lot of the music that you've done and been a part of too. It's like you hear something and it makes you hear something. It's not like you hear like you need to do what they did. It makes you hear what you could do. And so that's what Dexter Story's music did for me on that piece. I want to pay tribute to that.
I totally get that. Let's play Queen of the South. Closes with a beautiful track called A Kind Word, which seems to sum up the whole album to me.
I didn't learn how to drive until I was 30 years old. And the only reason I learned how to drive was because I needed to take my wife to the hospital when she was having our first child. And otherwise, I'd still be riding the bus. But I remember just like getting on the bus and just seeing people just going about their day and wondering if anybody had even just said like, hey, hello, or just dropping a kind word to somebody. And that was one of the things about my dad. My mom and my dad, both of them, they've always been really kind people, and they would always like reach out to people and just say, hey, how you doing? And in a real genuine way. And I think that sometimes, especially in the climate we're in right now, where there's too many hateful words being bandied about, that just to that kind of sentiment of empathy for our brothers and sisters out there is really so important. So I think that's what that song kind of speaks to, at least to me.
That's A Kind Word from Ron Miles' new album, Rainbow Sign. Man, it's a beautiful, reflective, it's a soothing album. I love it, man. It's a really calming influence in some turbulent times. It's A Kind Word. Congratulations on making such beautiful music.
Well, thank you, Don. And again, man, it means just the world to me. You're somebody whose music has meant a lot to me through the years, and that you heard it and liked it is just, like I say, just makes my heart swell, man.
Okay, man. Well, I can speak for everybody at the label, man. We're proud to have you on the roster. Thanks for joining us. And thanks for being with us on First Look today. See everybody next time. Thank you, man. If you enjoyed First Look and would like to see more, please hit the subscribe button and also click the bell icon. That way, you'll be notified when we post our next video.